guys, it's Karen, and this is going to be my July and August favourites of beauty products. And I haven't filmed a video like this for a long time, but I'm hopefully sorted out my computer problems and can do this again every month now that I've moved and things are a little bit more settled down. And I've got a lot to show you today, so I'm just going to get started right away. Eyeshadows. Got two favourite eyeshadow palettes. The first one is a Wet n Wild palette. I don't know what shade it is, but it's got a nice sort of taupey colour, a light sort of dusky pink colour, and a neutral sort of beigey colour as the highlight. And my favourite other big palette is the Undress palette by MUA. I really like this palette because it's so neutral, and you can see the shades that I've used a lot, which are this one here, and I use this brown here for my eyebrows. I've used this one a few times, a nice bronzy colour. I haven't really used these two colours at the moment, and I've used this copper colour. So this is really good. This is worth £4 and it's got many great looks. I'm wearing a couple of the shades today, but my camera's not that good that you'll pick it up. Okay, we'll go to blush next. The next thing, I've got two favourite blushes and two favourite bronzers. This one is the Stralis Paparazzi Perfect blush in Shoot to Thrill. And it's just like a mineralizey kind of thing. You just swirl the brush around and you get the dark color and the light color, or you can pick whichever color like you like. Comes with a mirror and it's in Shoot to Thrill. Love this one. I want to get some more of these blushes. Next one is another MUA product, and this is their Mosaic blush. That's again, you swirl the brush and you get all the colors or whichever color you like. It's really pretty. I'm wearing it today, and this one's in shade 3 English Rose bronzer, and I've got two bronzers. This one I've had a while and I decided to dig it out because it's got shimmer in it. It's from I think it's a Korean brand, A.K. and you can see it's got loads of shimmer in it, and it's just a really nice bronzer, and you can see that I've used it more in the middle than the outside. Gotta be really light-handed with it because the shimmer goes everywhere. And then an old faithful, which is the e.l.f. contouring and bronzing powder kit. I've had this a while and I dug this out again. This is the blush and it's really pretty. This is the bronzer. I haven't used the bronzer as much as I'd like, but I'm going to try and use that this month more than this glittery one, because I think this is more an everyday bronzer. The next thing is, I've only got one favourite mascara, and it's an Astralis one, and this multi-mega lash, I should say. And I'm not wearing it at the moment because I only put my mascara on just before I go out. And I've got another hour and a half before I'm going out, so I'll put this on before I go, but it's got a really nice wand. You can see it's not a plastic wand, it's a hairy brush wand, and this is the color, and I think this is in Blackest Black. I don't know if the camera will pick that up. Sorry, I'm looking at the natural light coming in and it's making my eyes water. Okay, get on. Two more things. I've got so much more to show you because I haven't done any of these videos for a long time. This one is the Revlon Mousse Photo Ready Airbrush Foundation in 020 Shell. And I absolutely love that. That's the shade and I'm wearing it today. Love that. I've been trying to use that more because I think I purchased that a little while ago and it's sat in my drawer for a few months, so I'm trying to wear it more. Also another MUA product, which is the BB cream, and I really like this one as well. I find it works best without a primer on my face. because my face is sensitive, but it's also has an oily zone, and I don't like the way it looks with a primer underneath, so I wear this without a primer and I just dab it and then blend it. But with this one today, I actually use my hands to put this in because it dries really quickly, but I really like those things. Now we get on to lips. I've got four lip favorites. I'll get it out in a minute. This one is no longer available, but I absolutely love the color. It's a Charlotte's Perfection brush on mineral lip gloss in Picasso, and I actually picked this up at Farmers for something like $1.50 or $2.50 in the clearance section, and that's the thing, you just pump it and it comes out. I'm using the lid, and that's the color. It's like a nice sort of mauvey rose gold color, rose pink color, I mean. So I wish you could still get that, but you can't, so I'm using this sparingly, but I do like it. On my lips today, I'm wearing a new purchase that I hauled last week, and I'll leave the link below for that. This is the Face of Australia Sheer Gloss Lip Crayon, and it's in the shade Macaroon. And I'm wearing it on my lips today. Blowing you a kiss. And I really like this colour, and I like Cupcake, so I haven't worn that one as much. I've worn this more. It's a darker pink and I like it. I've got another Australis product, and this is the lipstick Colour Inject Mineral Lipstick in Salsa. Love that colour, and it's just really nice. It's looking red, but it's a nice dark pink. I like dark pinks and light pinks, so I really like that. And the last lip product is MNY Lip Gloss. I wear this on its own or over the lipsticks that I've showed you, and it's in 804A, and it's just a really nice, I really love the packaging of these. It's just a really nice mini sort of applicator. I've used this tons, but I've still got tons left. I like the packaging more than the normal Maybelline packaging, so I definitely want to find some more of those. This thing is, I'm going to do scents. The next thing is scents, and this is the Terry Mugler Angel, and you can see that it's not very much left. I'd say less than half full. Absolutely love this. It smells like pralines and chocolate, and it's very strong, but if you get a chance, smell it and see if you like it. But remember, once you've sprayed it, to let it sort of dry down a little bit before you smell it, because sometimes when you put it on, you put on a little bit too much and it smells really strong and you instantly think, oh, I don't like this. So spray it, let it dry down for a few minutes, and then smell it, and I think you'll like it. So this is a refillable bottle. It's a 30ml, and I'm going to get this refilled when this runs out, because I've found two refilling stations, which is better for the environment to have it refilled than buying up new bottles. And I really like the design of the bottle, and I would definitely get this refilled again and again and again, as I have done in the past. And it's my favourite perfume of all time. Then I've got a new Victoria's Secret, which I hauled last week. Yeah, I know, I've only had it a week, but I've already used tons of it because I absolutely love it. So I had to include it, and it's the Coconut Passion Victoria's Secret Body Mist. And it's 250ml. And I absolutely love it. Wearing this today, and it makes me so happy because it's coconutty and it just smells beautiful. And I've had a few compliments already on what I'm wearing, or what's that smell. So really like that, and I definitely will get more Victoria's Secret when I can. Then we're coming up to the final things, but there's still quite a few. I've got the thing that I also hauled last week or the week before, which is the Aveeno Daily Moisturizing Lotion, and this is again in a big size. It's got natural colloidal oatmeal, and it's fragrance free and it relieves and protects your dry skin. I use this mainly on my legs and my arms, and then I put my sun cream on. I don't know if this has any SPF in it. Let me have a look. I don't think it has any SPF in it because it doesn't say that I can find. But I do use my Aveeno skincare system first, then I use this, and that already has some skincare in it, some SPF in it. And if I'm going out to the beach or going for a run, I will put a sun cream on anyway. So yeah, I really like this. It's really moisturized my legs and my arms, and I really like it. So it's just a really nice pump, which took me ages to get open, but it now works. And now I've got nail polishes, and I've got a lot of nail polish to show you. Colour Club in Yum Gum, and that's a bright, I would say a candy pink, a bit darker than a candy pink. And I have worn this, and I will put a link to that below. Love that. Also, because it's spring now, I'm loving the mint colours, so I've got the Revlon Minted. I've had this a while. I think I bought it in January. So I'm loving the mint and the peach and the coral and the bright pink and the neon. So I'm really getting into that. I also hauled this a couple weeks ago, and this is Pinking of You, which is an OPI classic pink colour. It's just a really neutrally pink that you could use for a French polish, or just normal if you don't want to look like you're wearing a lot of nail polish. For school or university, you could get away with using that. Then I've got my favourite orange, which is the C&D, I think it's called Electric Orange. And I absolutely love this colour, and I've worn it quite a bit. So if I can remember where my link is for this, I'll put that below as well. And then upon a friend's recommendation, I got the Nicole from OPI Court is Ready for a Petty Kardashian colour, and it's really nice red. It's coming out orange on here, but I've got a blue light on my camera, so I think that's why. But it's a really nice appley red. I like that colour. And then I've got the final nail polish, which is a top coat, and it has strengthening and holographic reflective flakes, and it's by Astralis, and it's called Spectacular. And I absolutely love it. It's just a hollow flaky, and it's a really nice top coat. I'm not wearing it today, but I have worn it quite a few times. And the final two things are the hand cream, which is a Korean hand cream. I got it from a cheap shop. Really love how moisturizing this is. It's not greasy. It just sinks into the skin and really is so nice. And it's an organic one. I think I paid like $2.50 for this. And then my final thing is the Liz Earle Hot Cloth Cleanser. I've got a couple of these mini sizes left that I bought, and then I'm going to get another big size. But I like this because it's got no animal extracts in it, and it's just really nice with the muslin cloth, and it really nicely cleans and softens my face, and I just really like this product. So that's my July and August favorites in my new house, and I hope that you like this video, and I'll speak to you again soon. If you've got any questions, please leave them below, and I'll try and answer them as quickly as I can. So thanks for watching, and I'll speak to you again soon. Bye.